Nano Banana Pro is finally here, and it's a pretty big upgrade. It can now generate native 4K images, handle text much more cleanly, and even blend multiple subjects with way better accuracy. And yes, it can use Google search in the background to generate accurate data inside your images. Pretty wild, right? In this video, I'm going to show you some incredible use cases of this powerful image model that can actually help you a lot in your daily workflow. Now, let's start with how much better the Pro model is compared to the old Nano Banana. To demonstrate this, here's an example prompt I used with both models, and the results are surprising. In the prompt, I asked for a wine glass filled completely to the brim and a clock in the background showing 5:30. The old Nano Banana model gave me these images where, as you can see, none of them really follow the instructions. The wine glass is only half full, and the clock doesn't show 5:30. But the Pro model, on the other hand, generated exactly what I asked for. The glass is full, and the clock shows the correct time. So now you get the idea. The Pro model is much better at understanding your words and executing your instructions accurately. Now let's move forward with some interesting use cases of this model. All right, the platform we're using today is Artlist, and they are kindly sponsoring today's video. Artlist has everything a creator needs: stock music, footage, and now all the advanced AI models. You can generate AI videos, images, and even voiceovers, all inside a single platform. If you want to try Nano Banana Pro and everything else Artlist offers, now is the perfect time. Their holiday sale gives you 40% off annual AI plans or 20% off the Max Pro annual plan. And you'll also get 2 extra months free when you use my link below. All right, so head over to Artlist and open the AI image section. You'll see this interface with two options: text to image and image to image. And as you can see here, I've selected the Nano Banana Pro model. Now for the first use case, I want to show you how good this model is at blending multiple subjects into a single image. Here's the reference image I'm using. You can see there are a bunch of different characters mixed together. So first, switch to the image to image tab and upload your image. Then I use this prompt: a medium shot of all the characters from the reference image, sitting squeezed together side by side on a worn beige fabric sofa and on the floor. And I added a few more details. After generating, this is the result. And as you can see, all those weird characters from my reference image are now seamlessly placed together. Most of their identities are maintained really well. Not perfect, but honestly still impressive. Here's another example. I combined multiple random photos, and even this anime guy, into one image in Photoshop. Then I use the prompt: create an Oscar Knight-style celebrity selfie featuring all the characters from the reference image. And this is what I got. Again, it did a surprisingly good job keeping everyone recognizable. Not 100% identical, but definitely the best we have right now. And here's one more: all of them on a wooden boat in the middle of the ocean. Even here, the model kept most characters very close to the reference, including the anime character. And not just that, Nano Banana Pro can also generate multiple famous people in one single image. So here's an image I created where we have 7 tech CEOs together in a wrestling arena. As you can see, we have Elon Musk here, Tim Cook, Mark Zuckerberg, Sundar Pichai, Satya Nadella, Jensen Huang, and Sam Altman, all in the same shot. And another crazy thing is that this is a native 4K image, so when I zoom in, you can see all of them are highly accurate and extremely well-rendered. Now, if you try the exact same prompt with Cedrine 4, you'll get results like these. Completely random people. It can't even generate one of them properly. Here's the result from the base Nano Banana model. And again, it's unable to generate any of the celebrities I mentioned. And this is the result from Google Imagen 4. It managed to generate a few of them, but not all, and the accuracy just isn't there. So as you can see, right now we have only one model that can generate a 4K image containing multiple famous celebrities in a single frame, and that's Nano Banana Pro. All right, now the next use case is really interesting. You can actually use map coordinates in your prompt, and Nano Banana Pro will generate images based on that location. So as you can see here, I have the coordinates for the Matterhorn Mountain in the Alps. All you have to do is copy these coordinates, go to Artlist, switch to the Text to Image tab, and write a prompt like, create an image of this coordinate at sunset, and you'll get a result like this. It's insane how it can create an image from just the coordinates. It knows the exact location because it uses Google search in the background. That basically gives this model steroids. Here's another example. I used the coordinates of NASA and added the date and time of the Apollo 11 mission, and it generated this rocket launch image. Then I tried generating the Titanic sinking using just the coordinates, date, and time. And it still worked. Isn't that wild? All right, the next thing you can do is create these blueprint-style infographics on literally anything. This is the prompt you can copy and paste. You just have to change the subject. It can be a landmark, a car, or anything you want. In this example, I used the prompt to generate this blueprint-style image of the F&F Tower. And honestly, it blew my mind. The text it generated is highly accurate with almost no gibberish. I double-checked the data on Google and most of it was correct. So yeah, this feature is actually really useful. Here's another example. You can upload your own image too. I uploaded this F1 car photo, used the same prompt again, and got this amazing result. I don't see any major errors in the text. It looks highly accurate. And the way it draws the diagrams across the body is super cool. All right, the next use case of this tool is that you can generate highly accurate infographics like these. You can take an article from a website like Medium and turn it into a full infographic image. For example, I copied this article titled 6 Proven Principles to Learn Any Skill Faster and pasted it into Artlist with the prompt, "Turn this article text into an infographic image." The article was around 800 words, which worked fine. But if you have a longer article, you'll need to trim it down to around 800 words. And here's the result I got from that prompt. It looks amazing. The design, the fonts, and the illustrations are visually very clean and professional. The text is also mostly accurate and on point, and it actually showcases the 6 principles from the article in a clear, visual way. Here's another one. This time I shortened the article using ChatGPT and made it very precise for the prompt, and it gave me this amazing infographic. Just like before, the text and visuals are very accurate. I'm seriously impressed by how well Google nailed the text and design on this model. And it's not just articles. You can generate infographics on any topic, and you can even specify a style. For example, here I used a prompt asking for a photography-style DIY infographic that explains how solar energy works. And look at this. It created a beautiful image with tiny cardboard pieces that clearly explain the topic. I also tested whether it could generate an infographic directly from a blog post link, but it didn't work. As you can see, I gave it the Nano Banana Pro blog link and asked it to create an infographic, but it only picked up the model name from the URL. All the information it generated was wrong and not from the actual blog post. All right, for the next example, I gave it a sketch of a scene where a person is falling off a cliff and another person is holding their hand. Along with the sketch, I also provided 2 separate images, one of a man and one of a woman, plus a background image of a beautiful mountain. In the prompt, I asked it to blend all these images together, match the sketch's composition precisely, use the man as the hero and the woman as the one slipping. And this is the result it generated. And look at how closely it matches the reference sketch, the composition, and everything we asked for in the prompt. This is literally how you bring your sketches to life. All right, so I also tried generating YouTube thumbnails, and as you can see, these are the results from Nano Banana Pro. Honestly, this thing is insanely good at designing thumbnails. All of these came out looking really clean and professional. I tried the exact same prompts with C-Dream 4 and the older Nano Banana model, and these are the results. And you can clearly see they're nowhere near the visual quality that Nano Banana Pro is producing here. It's clearly a big upgrade. All right, this post is going viral on the internet. Someone gave Nano Banana Pro a photo of a notebook with a handwritten equation and asked it to solve it in the same handwriting. And just look at this. It not only solved the equation correctly, but also matched the handwriting perfectly. This is literally a game changer for students and anyone in education. So that's all for this first look at the capabilities of Nano Banana Pro. You can try it out right now on Artlist. The link is in the description. I'll be making another video with more unique use cases, so be sure to like and subscribe to the channel.